So I'm very excited to be joined right now by the runners-up of Love Island, Lan and Ron.
Hey, you're right.
Hi guys, how are you?
We're doing really good, thank you. How are you?
Good. Well, I'm great. I'm delighted to meet the two of you. You were two of my favourites. And as they say, runners-up always do best. Do you feel that's been the case for you both?
We never actually know whether to believe you if you say your favourite. So many people come up to us and say you is our favourite, and we never know whether to believe them or not.
Well, Ronald, you and I are wearing matching hoodies, so I feel like we already have a bond. We already have a bond. And in the beginning, I was like, Ron, pull yourself together. She is an incredible girl. What are you doing? And then you came full circle.
Yeah.
And you guys seem to be like living 6 weeks out of the villa. You're living like a proper couple life. Like, you're not really doing a lot of Love Island-y things, which I love to see. You're just spending time together. How's it going?
It's going really well. I feel like you said, we're not really doing the Love Island things. We're just doing the things that we would have done pre-Love Island, like the normal stuff, the going out together, just going for Nando's and doing all nice bits.
Spoons.
We're just enjoying each other's company at the minute, which is nice, isn't it? It's working well for us.
Yeah, we said we don't want to be this, like, everyone has like a sort of perception of what it's like after the villa and everyone lives like this mad lifestyle and goes to all these fancy places. We're not interested in it, you know. We just wanted to be normal people. We wanted to be ourselves coming out, and I feel like we're doing it, so we're all right.
Been great.
You definitely are, and I think that comes across, which is hopefully why you guys will last. And I love the way as well you kept yourselves quite private until you came out. And I just think that's classy. I love the way you guys have played it, and I follow you both on Instagram.
Thank you.
This is a bit long distance, isn't it? So Ron, you're Essex, you're Manchester, Lana, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So how are you finding the long distance life?
We have only had probably 6-7 days apart since we've left the villa. Yeah. So we've actually managed to be together more than we've been apart. And just when I've got work down in London, he's here, so I stay with him. And then when I go back up to Manchester, you come with me. So we've not had it that bad. Like, I feel
I think we're like, I've found it really quite easy because I don't mind just sticking my tunes on, having a little jam in the car for 3.5 hours. And the thing is, when I go up there, like, we're going up, I think we're going up on Thursday, so what's that, tomorrow? So I'm going up there and I'm going to be there for like 2 weeks because I've got a lot of work up there. And then obviously after that, I've then got some charity stuff down here, so I'll come down and then you'll have work there. So
our diaries have aligned very well, so we've been able to spend a lot of time together, which is nice.
Well, I love that. Hopefully that continues. And Lana, has Ron changed coming out of the villa? Because he said in the final,
have I changed?
Finally.
He's just got a bit more annoying.
But you're getting to know each other. I saw you posted something about having the ultimate ick because he had his like head.
He doesn't stop gaming. Now that we've got a bit more comfortable together on the outside, all he does is game.
Honestly, I think every bloke will probably agree with this. When the girls, right, when you're in the shower and when you're doing your makeup for an hour and a half, I'm not going to sit there and I don't want to scroll. I can't stand looking at socials. So I'd rather talk to my mates.
I mean, fair point. I'm sure, does Lana have any ex? No, she's perfect. She's a princess.
I tell you, when you put the headset on.
Yeah, but you put the headset on me.
No,
I don't have any ex.
I don't think.
I tell you what, mess is there.
I'm not that messy. He's just a clean freak. That's what it is.
I mean, a little bit of mess. She's a girl. She's going to have stuff. And she's living out of a suitcase. So you need to give her a vibe on that one.
I have given her a wardrobe, though.
No, you haven't.
Given her a section.
You've given her a section. It better be a big section because you know girls need more.
Well, I've said what's mine is yours. So use as much space as you want.
Ron, you've changed. Your first girlfriend, and you're learning so quickly. We're all very
proud. Yes,
so some questions about Love Island that I really want to pick your brains. So, how long do you have to get ready every night before you had to like run into the villa, the outside bit, and pretend like you're having a party?
So it ranged really. Some nights we would get like 2 hours where we could just take our time getting ready, and then some days it'd be like, right, you've got half an hour, just get ready, and then we'd be like, oh my god, I've not even showered yet. So it really d- depended, but you just slept whilst we got ready, didn't you? So they just had a jolly, slept upstairs.
I wouldn't say we had a jolly. We were stuck in one room and we had to wait for you. And then even on the nights that you had 2 hours, there was always someone that would be like, last minute dress change.
Yeah, yeah. There was always some sort of, like, because we didn't have like, we had outfits, but you run out of outfits after, I think I must have had 3 weeks of solid outfits and then I was running out. So by the time it gets to like the end weeks, you're like, I actually do not have anything to wear. And eBay would supply some bits, but and then it was like dog eat dog, like all the girls would go and grab the dresses and it would be like trying to fight for the dresses. But in the end, it was just like, I haven't got anything to wear. And it was a bit of a meltdown, but yeah, it was about...
You looked nice regardless, so don't worry.
She did. She did. I'm obsessed with the dress that you wore for, you know, the night we did the couple speeches and you kind of had the ball, the pink and the black.
Oh, yeah.
You pick
that,
all your own.
That was hit and miss. Like, I read some things where people are like, what were you wearing? But and then I've seen other people saying it was nice.
Well, I also have that dress, so I am a big fan. And I saw you and I was like, yes, oh my gosh, it looks so much better. I will take that as
love that.
Okay, so tell me then a little bit about when you were in the villa, did you ever hear anything about the outside world? Is it that locked down? Like there's no contact, you don't know what's going on in the news, you've no idea how the public are perceiving you. What's it like?
So I did.
What did you know?
I was a bit cheeky. I was very much I was a bit cheeky in the villa. So when I'd get selected to go on dates and when I'd leave the villa, I'd basically really try and get the cabbie to give me a little bit of information.
Yeah, but he wouldn't want juicy information. He would want the football scores.
That is the juice. The one thing that I wanted was football scores for the boys. I got them and then they caught on to what I was doing. So then they was literally like telling the cab drivers, do not say a word. And I had to try so hard. I tried every tactic in the book. I got bits and pieces. But yeah, they did catch on.
I don't think the girls got told much. Like at lunch, I'd be like to, because there was producers that came round at lunch and just seen how you were. And I used to always ask them like, have you got anything you can tell us? I just want to know one piece of like any information from the outside. And I think they told us something like really, really not that interesting. Like Miley Cyrus has got a new song out and it was that Flowers song. And then everyone was so curious to listen to it, but we couldn't play it. But that was it.
That was it. And of course, Ron got told off for getting info from cab drivers taking you on the dates. Yeah. But
I just had to do it. There's something about it that I needed to break a rule. So I just thought, yeah, if I can get football scores. But the thing was, it was causing me more pain because I was finding out that Man United were nearly in the title race again. And then we lost 7-0, which we found out. And then it was just all, it actually made me quite upset. Me and Kai were literally just, we wanted to know football. That was it.
And any other times you got told off?
I was bad.
Yeah.
In what way?
Ron's problem was that he tried to be a producer. So he tried to know everything that was going in. That was going on and everything that was about to happen. He'd be like, I think tonight this is going to happen. I think tonight, and you're not allowed to speculate. And then he would just constantly get told off as trying to work out what was going to happen in the show.
It's just fun. Like I couldn't control anything in there, right? But if I could just prepare myself, like if I, for me, it's one of them where if you like, what's the saying? Prepare for the worst.
Hope for the best.
No, yeah, but
if you feel prepare, you prepare to feel.
Yeah, exactly. So what I was doing was I was basically going, there's definitely going to be a dumping tonight. So then I'd have it in my mind that there's a dumping. And then if you got the text, you kind of expected it. So you wasn't as sort of like, ooh.
Were there ever any conversations or any scenes that had to be reshot? Or is it as live as it looks?
I think the day-to-day and everything that goes on that you see is kind of live. Yeah. I think when you see slow-mos and when you see...
Yeah.
Walk-ins of bombshells and stuff like that, that's when they have to get shot here, shot here, shot here, shot here. They want all the shots, so that's the type of things that get like filmed more than once.
Yeah, like dates, or like, I don't know if you remember, you know the baby day, you know where the boys went to the little playground?
Yes.
Like that is a lot of taking it from different shots because you're obviously in, you know, you're outside the villa in a play area.
Yeah.
It's hard getting different shots because it's not they have to like bring a separate film crew that leave the villa with you. So yeah, so like dates, final date.
Yeah, dates aren't really, they're just stop-starty, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's hard to have like a natural date because you're very conscious of the fact that there's a camera crew around you, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there's about 30 people around you. So dates feel a bit like it's not just you and that person. It's a bit, it's a bit strange.
It sounds intense. Obviously, it was worth it for you guys. You met each other. You're super happy. You're giving it a go, which is amazing. Is there anything you regret about going on the show, or has it just been the best thing ever?
I'm the sort of person, I never live with regrets, so I don't regret a thing, do you?
I wouldn't say I regret it. I think that's very harsh of me to say I regret it, because I've come out, I've got Lana, and I never had an experience before. Like, you know, I never went uni, I never traveled. So this was an amazing experience for me. I think it's more the fact that there's some really, really hard times in there, like when feelings are involved and things like that. And I feel like I just wish they never happened. So I don't know whether it's a regret. I just wish certain things never happened.
I think that's natural. Did you watch it back or not?
Absolutely not.
We've seen little clips on TikTok where it shows like snippets of like best bits or worst bits.
Yeah.
We've seen them. So they're quite funny to watch, aren't they? But we've not seen an actual... Yeah. Actually, I did watch the Family Day episode because I wanted to see my mum and my best friend come in. But that's it.
That was such a lovely show. How's your dad, Ron? He seems like quite a character.
Everyone says this. He's all right. I think he very much enjoyed the whole thing of it, which I was so surprised with. He's exactly like me. He is a pain in the ass. So I can kind of like, I think he was a producer's nightmare as well when he got flown out there. But no, he's good. He's loving it. He comments on all of my stuff.
He does comment on everything, yeah.
Oh, it's like a little dad celebrity. Love that.
Yeah, it really is.
And Kai and Sanam, who won the show, seemed really close. Are you guys still close now? And do you chat to any of the rest of the cast?
So we are really close with Kai and Sanam. We see them as often as we can, don't we? Because
we've had quite a few double dates.
When we're in the same city, we'll be like, oh, we're here, let's do something. So we've had a couple of double dates and we're seeing them next week.
I'm seeing him Sunday. I'm going to the Man United game with him.
Yeah.
No way. Oh,
and then I'm playing in two charity football matches with him as well.
Yeah.
So I'm seeing him pretty much every week for a lot.
And then we're also quite close to Tanyel, aren't we? I speak to Tanyel quite often. I think, you know, it's just hard to, there's so many people that came out of Love Island. It's so hard to keep up with absolutely everyone. You have people that I'll be like, oh my God, I've not spoke to them in ages. And I'll just drop them a text saying, I'm sorry for being rubbish, but how are you doing and stuff like that. Yeah. But it's just so hard to keep up with everyone.
I think you're just going about it the right way, living your best life and enjoying getting to know each other. So it's been so nice to talk to you guys. Congratulations.
Oh, you came across
so well on the show. And I'm delighted things are still going great for you both. Thank you for coming on Cool FM. And just before you go, give us a little shout out for your socials so that people could give you a follow.
Oh, so I am just Lana Jenkins with two S's on my Instagram, TikTok and my YouTube, I think.
I think I'm Ron Hall __.
Yeah.
__. That is important.
For some reason, Ron Hall was already taken. So
you're verified now. People will be able to find you.
I know, mental. Runners, what's going on there?
Thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you so much for having us.
Have a lovely day.
Come on! Hey, baby! Let's go!
Northern Ireland's number one for music.
Cool FM.